behind me is the 2004 Cruisers Yachts 540. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer.
Here we are, starting at the bow of the Cruiser Yachts 540. And as you can see, we have the spotlight controller, nice large anchor powered by a large electric windlass. As we make our way down the port side hull, the vessel has just been buffed, waxed, and is going through the complete detailing process. But as you can see, this is quite an impressive vessel with some really beautiful lines. Working our way to the transom of the yacht, you can see here just again how they carry this windshield around, macrolon glass there, a large aft bimini, and then there is a sunshade that kind of goes around that to enclose the cockpit for storage use. Making our way to the transom, we have a large hydraulic swim platform here. This is great for loading a dinghy, jet skis, and all your toys, easily deploying it and retrieving it out of the water. And again, just uses a great amount of space just for being able to lounge out here. These chocks are also removable, so it does create a full flush area. But as you can see, the hull just sparkles. And again, as they kind of are going through the fine, kind of fine detailed items here, this is going to be looking really, really nice. We have a fusion controller here at the transom of the vessel with speakers, large bench seat, additional storage, swim step with a ladder integrated into here. And we're making our way up into the aft cockpit. We have a hot and cold swim step shower. There is a enclosure gate that closes off this area. So if you have kids or animals, that definitely keeps them in. There's also an storage unit located here, Corian, kind of a countertop bar area, built-in cup holders, and again, just a amazing amount of space back here for entertaining. This is an electric slide that comes out, encompasses this area for a full lounge, but it can be used as seating as well. There's also a built-in receptacle for a cockpit table if so desired. Large refrigerator behind this door. We have the barbecue sink underneath this. Fusion stereo. This is the AV755 with Fusion speakers. And again, there's just a lot of boat to take in, but really want to just kind of go through and slowly deliver it to you so you can experience this. I'm going to take you up to the bow. And so with easy access here, with really nice grab handles, you can see the accessibility up to the bow is quite easy. This is a large area up here, great sun pad. We have an Fusion stereo controller up here. And then again, overhead access to the master cabin and our anchor chain locker with controls. All right, so making our way back, you can see large windows again, this newer macrolon glass. This is really impressive stuff because, I mean, it looks like you're looking through a glass windshield, but it gives you that really nice look and style. Above here, we have our KVH track vision, our newer Garmin radar, and GPS antennas. Engine room access is located right through this compartment. This just lifts up. You have steps that are associated right here off to the port side, but great access down here. We have our dual Raycor fuel filter systems for the port engine. Centrally located is for our generator and off to our starboard engine. So again, if one clogs up, switch it over. And now you have a full backup system here. These are Volvo D12s. So it's powered by two Volvo D12s with the V drives. So you can see the V drives down here. And I believe those are newer shaft seals, but they look in really good condition. The engine room itself is nice and clean. It's been very well taken care of. You can see 4221. Both engines were fully serviced. Centrally located aft is the newer Kohler generator. I believe this has about 130 hours on it. I do have the full pictures in the listing as well. And then as we make our way around here, obviously lots of batteries. We have battery chargers. We have our engine control switch here, so you can start and stop the engines from down here as well too. Battery chargers, access to the RAM system here for our steering, hydraulic, autopilot system. This is our Glendenning cable system. So this allows us to push a button and it retrieves the 50 amp shore cord, making it quite nice. But again, a really large, clean, accessible engine room. Engines, you know, obviously for their age and hours, they show very well. And like I said, I've just been recently serviced. Fireboy system centrally located here. And again, a quick spin of the engine room. It's quite convenient to gain access down through there, and they've done a nice job. All right, so as we move up forward, we're gonna go to the helm station. Here you can see two captain's chairs. We have a new Cruisers panel that was just installed, bow thruster controller, newer Garmin GPS plotter, autopilot. These are both Volvo displays, our Bennett trim tab controllers, and our fuel tank gauges, rudder angle indicator. Slow down here. We have the VHF. This is an ICOM M602, a remote for the hydraulic swim platform. And I really love the electronic throttle systems. So again, really nice, it's angled quite nice. They have built-in stainless steel rails down here for your feet. And you have amazing, amazing visibility all the way around. Overhead, this beautiful skylight. You can see just how much light this light brings in. And again, just a real open, great entertaining spot. I mean, this is one thing that I know a lot of people like is with fly bridges, you know, sometimes you'll lose your crowd or you'll be up above driving the boat and everybody wants to go down below. But here you're in a, you know, nice, you know, pretty much one level protected area. Let's go down below and let me show you just how beautiful it is down here. Chris has done a great job. We're going to start at the galley. So we have a refrigerator in the cockpit with small freezer compartment, a large refrigerator here, freezer compartment there. I mean, tons of storage everywhere we go. And again, nice large Corian countertops, large stainless steel sink. We have a convection sharp microwave oven, a three burner electric stovetop. And then again, lots of storage and drawers. I really like this little feature. This is kind of like a little bar stools with a countertop nook here. And then a large Vizio TV. Here is the receiver for the DirecTV satellite system. And again, looking over to the starboard side of the vessel, there's this nice mirror, additional storage. We have our controls here to lower the table, to bring out the lounge. So it is quite versatile. I have some pictures of that in the listing. But again, when you look overhead, I mean, I just love the attention to detail, how they've done this nautical star here in the mirror. But I'm going to take you to the forward master cabin. But before we go there, we also have a dayhead access here to this head and shower compartment. Very large shower compartment. There is an opening hatch there, large mirrors, vanity, sink. And then to our forward master cabin, centrally located queen berth. Off to the starboard side, we have a full hanging locker closet. And what I really like is these steps allowing you great access into the bed, both starboard and port side. There is a built-in TV stereo receiver, air conditioning, heating controls, light switches, and then you do have access into the head and shower compartment from here as well. Making our way back aft, you can see this large seating area. Again, this little cubby here with these stools that will move around. Great accessibility, nice open floor plan, easy access out to the cockpit. Now I'm going to take you to the twin aft cabins. So the aft cabins are quite nice. As we come down below, you can see we have access to the dayhead, vacuum flush toilet, walk-in shower. Again, great use of space, really high headroom throughout the yacht. And then we have access to this aft cabin, full hanging locker here. And then just off to the starboard side, we have this cabin located here. Again, great use of space. And then behind this door, we have the Splendid washer and dryer. So that's set up quite nicely. Again, more storage above, below that, and just a really nice flow. All right, well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this Cruisers 2004-54, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this and to see firsthand what's coming on the market here in Southern California. Thank you again.